Aloha, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the worst program on the internet, the blues. This week, answering the question, do motorcycle safety instructors actually get into motorcycle accidents? Well, yes, we do. Yes, we do. I don't recommend it, by the way. Still kind of hurts, but it happens. What are you going to do, right? You know how this goes. Like, subscribe, post a comment, invite friends and family if you like what you see, or hopefully you have a little sympathy for the injured guy here. You know, I want to try something a little different today. I guess kind of a program in reverse, as it was. So here we go, from 2010, the great and sadly late Mr. Gary Moore. Check it out.
Remember Paris, 49, the Champs-Élysées, Saint-Michel and old Beaujolais. Well, and I recall that you were back at the photographs, those summer days spent outside corner cafes. Oh, I could write you paragraphs about.
Oh, shit. From 2010, that was Gary Moore, and his the song was Parisienne Walkway, which is probably, I guess, his first hit, as it were. Gary Moore was born in 1952 in Belfast, Northern Ireland. He and his family had moved to, just Ireland, Dublin, in 1968, just when the Troubles began, which has always been my favorite title for, I don't know, just war in the streets. The Troubles always makes it sound a little nice. He started playing guitar at the age of 10, influenced primarily by English players Peter Green and Eric Clapton as well. Played a number of different bands throughout the 70s, kind of going back and forth with Thin Lizzy, he being a childhood friend of Thin Lizzy vocalist and bass player Phil Lynott. And as you can see, there's really nothing that Peter Green couldn't or didn't play. His styles would often bounce between blues and hard rock, some heavy metal, jazz, fusion, and even some Irish folk tunes. And while I think that sort of variety helped him become just this genius on the guitar that he was, it probably did limit some of his commercial success. Probably one of my favorite things about, and maybe one of the most strange things as well, is about this, I guess, the career of Gary Moore was in 1998, 93, and 94. He was part of a power trio with, what they call the BB and M. We're talking about Jack Bruce, Ginger Baker, formerly of Cream, and of course, Gary Moore. Now, Gary Moore left that band, I guess, after about a year, citing hearing problems for one, and just, just all kinds of personal behaviors. It's always amazed me how it seems like from day one, Jack Bruce and Ginger Baker never got along. They just didn't seem to like each other. 40 years later, when they did the reunion concerts with Eric Clapton, I still don't think that they liked each other, but they played together a lot in a number of different bands, and Gary Moore was in one of those short-lived groups, and I guess probably because of those personality conflicts, that's why it didn't last, but unfortunately, we would lose Gary Moore in 1958. He actually died when he was in Spain on a vacation with his girlfriend. Later in life, Gary Moore developed a pretty serious drinking problem. And apparently when he was found dead in his hotel room, he had a blood alcohol level of, it says 0.38%. Now, apparently 0.4% is just considered lethal, and where 0.08, maybe at the time, I don't know what it is now, was just considered drunk. So it came to a sad and fast end for Gary Moore. But he did leave a legacy behind that was quite amazing. For as many people as inspired him, he inspired countless generations of other guitar players. In fact, actually, his... one of his most famous guitars, what he called Greeny, was a 1959 Les Paul that he bought from Peter Green for about £100. I don't know when he actually bought it, but in the in 2006 it was, he ended up selling that guitar because I think for health reasons and such, and apparently sold the guitar for roughly somewhere in the neighborhood of about $1 million. £100 in, I don't know, 1970. $1 million in 2006, not a bad return on investment. But then actually about 15 years later, Kirk Hammett of Metallica actually paid in the neighborhood of about $2 million for his guitar. So again, Gary Moore, we lost him so early, but his legacy, as you can see, just remains of just a true virtuosity, virtuoso on the instrument. So I hope you dug it. been meaning to do this for some time, and I do just listening to Gary Moore's guitar just soar is, I think, is something special. So please like, subscribe, post a comment, invite friends and family, whatever you like to do, and just keep listening and keep rocking, my friends. And of course, again, be safe on the bike, because it does hurt, and I still don't know what the insurance is going to cover. So we'll see you next time.